As I was trekking through reviews for this month of July, the last type of game I was expecting my final video review of the month to be was on a dating simulator. Yet, just this past week, a new visual novel dating sim has released on the PS Vita, PlayStation TV, as well as the PS4. Without further delay, I bring you coverage for a very wacky and very out there dating simulator. Here is my official review of Hatoful Boyfriend. In Hatoful Boyfriend, you play the role of a human girl that is attending a high school that was made for birds, specifically pigeons. At St. Pigeonation, you have been going to school some time now, and you're about to enter a new year. As you move into the new semester, you attend your first class and you meet a host of different birds, mostly male, and from different sections of the school, such as teachers, childhood friends, new classmates, and other types of people, like people from different clubs. To go along with the very comical idea of this dating simulator being between a human girl and male birds, the game is full of comedy and is clearly not to be taken seriously. It even has a lot of fan service to various other forms of media, such as referencing game series like Pokemon. Almost every scene is filled with comedy, and if you have any sort of sense of humor, you're going to be constantly laughing from start to finish. This game is a visual novel filled to the brim with dating elements. The progression of the game takes you from story scene in a very linear fashion. However, to make it not seem too linear and repetitive, there are a lot of different choices that you're shown as you play through the game. These choices go in the form of dialogue choices when you go through a certain scene, as well as choices of what events to go to and who to go to them with. The game has several different characters, and each of these characters has two endings associated with them, along with a few other endings you can achieve. How you get these endings depends on how much time you spend with these people, as well as your stats, which will be improved by going to electives, similar to how answering questions improved your stats in Persona 3 and Persona 4. The game runs on a calendar, so you have to be watchful of how much time you're spending with what character. If you don't reach intimacy status with a certain character by a certain point of the story, you'll immediately get a game over and get the bad ending. The key to getting endings is knowing who you want to get endings with and to spend as much time with them as possible. This will definitely require you to take a look at various events and save the game often, because you won't know who you'll be spending time with until after the event started. You can go back through the game again afterwards to get a good ending, but if you want to go only in one playthrough of the game, you'll need to save very often. Now, all in all, Hatoful Boyfriend isn't a very long game. A single run through the game could take you 1, maybe 2 hours, depending on how quickly you can read. You can definitely multiply this if you go through multiple endings, but for a visual novel, it's not a very long game. The only thing to say about controls are that the controls are simple, but it's worth noting that the game makes absolutely no effort in telling you how to use them. You can easily hit the start button to save the game in any dialogue sequence, but I had gone through half the game before I even knew you could save the game. This is something that they should have mentioned, and it is very unfortunate that you have to discover this on your own. Now, as far as the presentation, we've got a few good things, but a lot of things to discuss. The first thing is that the visual presentation looks great. All of the environments, text boxes, character models look absolutely flawless on the screen, and they should since they're all 2D renders. The problem with this is that this has a lot of technical problems. You would think that a visual novel would be super easy to run well on the Vita, but this game is definitely an exception. The first thing is lag. The main menu has a lot of lag when you put in options to go into a specific menu, like the gallery or the archive. And in dialogue sequences, whenever a new character's render is popping up on the screen, you will see noticeable lag. A few of the characters don't have this happen, but a few of them have it happen almost every single time they come on screen. Now, the final problem with the presentation is the audio. On several occasions, I've had the audio change from music to a very loud and annoying beeping noise for as much as 3 or 4 minutes before it'll finally go back to the background music. I know this is not intentional because I've saved and gone back through with the same scenes again, and this was not the case at all. The other part about the audio is that many times when you load a saved game, the music won't load at all until you get to the next scene. Hatoful Boyfriend is the most comical and wacky dating sim you will ever play. However, a host of technical problems, like lag and audio glitches, will hamper your experience. If you can look past these annoyances, that you're in for a very funny yet short journey. PlayStation Vita Reviews rates Hotiful Boyfriend a 6 out of 10. If you would like to comment on this, feel free to below, or go to my site and forum at forum.vitareviews.net and vitareviews.net. Also, if you'd like to check out PlayStation TV compatibility, I have a list that is linked below, and if you'd like to donate to my upcoming projects, that link is also set below.